Ever wonder what it's like being in a coma? Turns out it's even weirder than we imagined. There's no arguing that our understanding of the human mind and body has come a long way over the last couple of decades. But despite all the tremendous breakthroughs in science and technology in the recent years, there's still a whole lot that we don't know. Questions like, why do we have fingerprints? Why do we have different blood types? Do humans have pheromones? What happens when someone is struck by lightning? And many others have plagued scientists and doctors for generations. Although we've been able to answer some of these questions, many others have emerged as a result. As you can probably tell by the title of this video, one such question has to do with what we know about comas. Before we dive into some of the lesser understood intricacies, let's review what a coma actually is. According to the English dictionary, a coma is a state of deep unconsciousness that lasts for a prolonged or indefinite period of time, caused especially by severe injury or illness. Aside from that, we don't know much at all. Sure, modern medicine allows doctors to place dangerously unstable patients into a medically induced coma and then pull them out of it, but other than that, much information surrounding our unconsciousness remains speculative. Scientists are especially divided on whether or not coma patients can absorb and process what's happening around them, form new memories during their time under, and whether or not they can dream. The question about what it's actually like to be in a coma is a very curious one, and as of now, scientists and doctors are unable to definitively answer it. That being said, it doesn't mean that we have to keep guessing. A curious netizen decided to finally put this question to rest and post it to one of the biggest online communities, Reddit. Surprisingly, an overwhelming amount of people came forward and talked openly about what their coma experience was like. If you're curious to learn what it's actually like to be in a coma, then keep watching and find out. He started gaming. Reddit user DeadDave01 shared his 3-month experience in a medically induced coma. I remember all my senses coming online very strongly. I was super uncomfortable in that hospital bed. The lights were super bright and my mouth was super dry. Turns out I had an ischemic attack. As of today, I've pretty much recovered. I still do speech therapy, which I do in the form of a YouTube gaming channel because I do have a bit of a stutter. Car accident. Another person reported being unaware of losing consciousness or of any memories after the critical incident. I was in a coma after a car accident. I only remember one thing. I was walking down a street. I fell to my knees while coughing. I grabbed my throat. I looked down and saw my esophagus on the ground. I then fell onto my side. I learned later that was probably my vent tube coming out of the throat. Very long dream. While some people feel that no time has passed, others may experience it as a very long dream instead. A Reddit user shared their experience with a 3-month medically induced coma. I remember it was a very long dream. First, it was a nightmare. I was being chased by all these Chucky dolls with knives who were trying to murder me. Eventually, though, the dream shifted and Jesus came to me. He explained that he would take me to heaven if I was ready. My parents were there and they were very sad that I was going to leave them, and I remember thinking about it a lot and weighing all the options. But I finally decided I was going to go with Jesus. When I told Jesus I was ready, he smiled at me and said, "Sorry, it's not your time." He then went up into the sky and disappeared into the light. I was very upset because I was ready to go. Then I remember waking up and 3 months had passed. Still got the attitude. In some cases, coma patients may slip in and out of consciousness, making for very interesting anecdotes. One Reddit user shared her story of sibling rivalry during one such moment of clarity. "I was in a really bad car wreck a few months ago, and I effed up my internals and got an awful case of pneumonia. So they put me in a medically induced coma. I remember being awake a few times. The first time was when my sister came to visit. I've really fuzzy memories about what happened, but apparently the only thing I said was, 'Am I still prettier than you?'" Life on pause. For this lady, the 40s are literally the new 30s. A friend of ours fell into a coma at the age of 25, about 1992, and woke up at age 36, about 2002. She was a Rhodes Scholar nominee, I think secondhand information, and quite brilliant. She was still 25 mentally, as if everything was just on pause. Her body was really well preserved. She's really cool and fun and sort of the ultimate cougar. Plus, she totally woke up to the internet. Hallucinations. Another Reddit user shared her two-week dream filled with fantasy hallucinations and otherworldly beasts. I was in a medically induced coma for 2 weeks or so. I was on a lot of drugs and had some horrible hallucinations, an experience I'm told by ICU nurses is very common. I knew I was injured or in hospital. Apparently, they kept waking me up every day to check my brain function, but was not aware of why, so I spent a lot of time very confused. Vague hospital-based nightmares. Also, some Game of Thrones hallucinations because my brother visited and talked about the show at my bedside, and I fought a dragon as a result. I can't exactly say how much time passed because it was more than 2 years ago and I've tried to forget. Things from the outside broke in, but different times than you'd expect. The brain works in mysterious ways, especially when you're high AF. 'Twas all a dream. I spent 10 days in a medically induced coma following the birth of my youngest son. He'll be 3 years old this September. When I woke up, I remember being very upset about a conversation between two nurses that took place in my hospital room while I was sleeping. I've always wondered if that conversation really happened or if it was just a dream or nightmare. The White Room. Before I entered a coma, fell from a second story of a gym under construction and landed on my head, I had watched The Grudge. So during the whole coma, I dreamed that I was trapped in a completely white room with the Grudge Girl. She never moved and just stood there, but when I woke up from that coma, I refused to close my eyes for a couple of nights from fear. Lucidity. Someone with the username Catalyst Coin experienced partial lucidity in a comatose state. He claims to remember everything that happened around him. I was in a car accident at 18 and in a coma for 3 months. A couple of weird things happened. First, I was fully aware of everything for a couple of days before actually waking up. I couldn't open my eyes or move or talk, but I heard and felt everything. It was terrifying because I honestly thought it would last forever. After 2 days of this, I fell asleep, and when I woke up, I was fully conscious and never more relieved in my life. I thought at first that I had just slept for 3 months, but after a couple of weeks of being out of the coma, I started having the weirdest, most vivid recurring dreams and flashbacks of literally being another person. I'd never experienced anything like this before the coma. I've never had a recurring dream in my life, but since the coma, I've had the same 4 or 5 dreams hundreds of times, and in each one, I'm the same person, but not me. They're freaky, and I always wake up panicked and often find that I'm sleepwalking as well, and that also never happened before the coma. I'm pretty convinced that during the coma, I lived some other life in a super long and intense dream. It's the only explanation I can come up with. Last rites. Reddit user NZT48 told the story about his impeccable timing. After failing to wake up from his anesthesia for nearly 5 days, he regained consciousness as a priest was performing last rites on him. I had surgery. It was 9.5 hours. I didn't wake up. I have one memory of a nurse slapping me and screaming at me in the recovery room. Then nothing. It was like I was a TV that was unplugged. The next thing I know, I woke up to a priest saying last rites over me. I'm not Catholic. I croaked at him to F off because I wasn't going to die. He flees. A nurse comes running in and says, I've been in a coma for 4.5 days. I experienced nothing. I was here, then I was gone, then I was back. It was instantaneous. There was no sensation of the passage of time. Nothing. A Reddit user by the name Dana Scully's Revenge shared his story of a 3-week coma. Although he was pronounced dead several times over the course of his comatose condition, the worst has yet to come. I remember precisely nothing. Little flashes of faces and pieces of dialogue, maybe. Everything I know about that period was told to me by my parents' boyfriend at the time, and doctors and nurses. Maybe some people can hear what's going on around them while they're in a comatose state, but I wasn't one of them. When I awoke, I wasn't confused or anything. I recognized that I was in a hospital room, and I remembered being in the ER weeks before. It was the last thing I remembered. I thought maybe I'd been there a couple of days and had just slept off the worst of it. Then I saw the dry erase board on the wall in front of me where someone had thoughtfully written the date. Turns out the coma is the good part. The recovery afterward, learning to walk again because your muscles have atrophied, waiting for your voice to come back because you've been intubated all this time, trying to pee without help, and oh man, trying really hard not to get depressed is the worst part. The key to waking up. My friend told me that while he was snowboarding, he hit a tree, fell unconscious, and was airlifted to hospital in a coma for 2 weeks. While he was in a coma, he remembers walking in a field, a wolf by his side, walking toward a tree in the distance. For days, he wasn't getting any closer to the tree. Then suddenly, he and the wolf got closer and closer until they were at the tree. The tree was beautiful and it had a face, but the face kept changing faces, from people he had met in the past to people he met later in life. The tree reached its hand out toward him and was holding a key. He grabbed the key from the tree, held it to his heart, and the wolf disappeared. The tree disappeared, and he woke up. Come to the voice. Sometimes comatose patients are capable of hearing and processing auditory information. Reddit user No Please Stop shared one of her dad's anecdotes from the emergency room. My dad told me about this woman in a coma he saw during his residency. The experience taught him that you'd need to treat everyone like they're a fully aware and conscious person, even people in comas. Him and the other residents would all do their rounds. One woman was in a deep coma for weeks. Every time they'd come in, he'd say, "Hi, Miss So-and-so, I'm Dr. Whatever, and I'm just here to check on you." He talked to her like she was listening to him, explaining what he was doing to her step by step, and a lot of the other doctors thought it was kind of silly. I mean, she's in a coma, so she can't be listening, right? Well, time goes by, and the woman wakes up all of a sudden. They're doing their rounds, and he walks in the room and says something, and she immediately recognizes his voice. She came into the hospital in a coma and never saw the man, and never heard him talk while she was awake before that day. She immediately recognized his voice and says, "Oh, I remember you. You're the one that was so nice to me." Morphine dreams. Morphine is an incredibly powerful narcotic, but who knew that aside from being a potent painkiller, it was capable of triggering unbelievable dreams. I was in a medically induced coma for a week and a half, courtesy of a car accident. My family was at my bedside the entire time. Whenever I would move, they would calmly say to me that I'd been in a bad car accident, I was okay, and I was in a hospital. In my dreams, I was going about my daily business of college classes and coffee houses. The twist would be that I was introducing myself as having been in a bad accident, but I was okay in a hospital or in a class. I dropped a pen because my arm hurt, and the student in front of me says that, of course, my arm hurts because I was in a bad car accident, and so on. These morphine dreams varied, and were many, from the surreal to the mundane. Then I had the realization that if I've been in a bad car accident, then I should go to the hospital. So, in my dreams, I walk into the local college town's hospital, politely check into triage saying, "Hi, I've been in a bad car accident, but I'm okay, and I wanted to get checked out." That's when the nurses and doctors descended upon me in a life-saving frenzy. After that, I opened my eyes. Time moved slowly. When I was considered medically dead, I couldn't hear anyone. I was in a huge white room with no walls, just a floor. The floor would occasionally sparkle far off. I couldn't move. I could just look around and it was completely empty. I could still hear and feel emotions. I had a heavy feeling of being nervous and worried. It felt like I was sneaking into a place where I didn't belong, like a part of the house that was off limits to me as a kid. Time went by so slowly. I felt every second of it. It was only 4-ish minutes, but it definitely felt that long. I couldn't think, I just felt. It was the most terrifying experience of my life. I felt helpless. Everything was out of my control. I felt trapped. I don't remember, but when I revived, I screamed for minutes. I just screamed and cried. The King of Rock. Neighbor's kid was in a bad accident and was in a medically induced coma. The doctor said that he might be able to hear what they said, so sound upbeat, talk to him, play his favorite music, sports, etc. He liked Elvis, so they played his CDs almost nonstop. When he finally awoke from the coma, he thought he was Elvis. Took a long time for him to accept the truth. He had a very long recovering because of his traumatic brain injury. He now works as an Elvis impersonator. 100% truth. Everyone thinks I'm making it up when I tell him. Dream within a dream. We've talked about time moving slowly, but the opposite extreme can also hold true. A Reddit user by the name of Nitzlarb shared her story about her dad's uber-vivid experience. My dad was in a coma for about 2 months a couple of years ago. Recently, we were talking about the whole thing, and he told me that he had dreamed or hallucinated that he lived for 10 years and did all sorts of things during that time. He said it was very vivid, and he walked across the country a couple of times during it. When he woke up and got home, he said it would throw him off when he would run into people he hadn't seen before the coma, because at first he always expected them to have aged by 10 years. Unconscious but mobile. When I was 19, I visited my aunt during the summer holidays. I was playing my cousin's PlayStation, although I was tired from the journey since I didn't get proper sleep in the bus and had been awake for over 24 hours. I suddenly started getting an epileptic seizure and fainted. My mom and aunt screamed and tried to wake me up. The neighbors came in hearing the noise and took out their car to take me to the hospital. They brought me to the hospital and I didn't regain consciousness for almost 3 hours later. The crazy part is that when I lost consciousness, I was still able to get up, put on the jacket, get out the door in the elevator, got in the car, sat on my way to the hospital, opened the door of the car, and walked into the hospital before collapsing on the bed. I had absolutely zero recollection of any of this. Trapped inside my own body. I was in a medically induced coma for 6 weeks. There were a handful of times that I distinctly remember where I woke up in my head. What was the experience like? It sucked. When I would wake up in my head, I had no idea as to what had happened. So I'm fully conscious. I know that I'm me, but I can't open my eyes. I can't move a muscle, and I can't speak. The first time it happened was terrifying. I started to panic, and for a minute there, I thought I might be dead. Then I realized that I was thinking, so I didn't seem right. I tried to move and couldn't. I tried to speak and couldn't. I tried to scream and couldn't. I realized at that point that if I didn't calm myself down, that I would go crazy inside my own head, and no one could help me. Though I was on a ventilator, in my head I did deep breathing exercises. I listened to the clicking of machines and tried to focus on those. Then I started counting the sound of something that seemed repetitive. That gave me enough to focus on until I eventually drifted off again. Tied down. Reddit user CyberclawX spent nearly a week in a coma, but unlike most patients, his hallucinations were very much more extreme. As a result, doctors had to take extra measures to assure his safety. A little over a week on the other side, my coma hallucinations were pretty bad. I kept trying to fight everyone. Everyone, friends, family, and doctors, was out to hurt or humiliate me to the point they strapped me to the bed so I wouldn't hurt anyone or myself. When I finally stopped hallucinating, I was so tired of running away and fighting, think Inception or Dreams, I felt I was in there for months, that I didn't even care much for the fact I'd lost an arm. I was just glad it was over.